The Productivity 3000's Ethernet IP feature makes using the Advantech ADAM Remote I/O a snap. We just want the input data collected by the ADAM module to appear in the Productivity 3000. And we want the output data written to a tag in the Productivity 3000 to appear on the outputs of the ADAM Remote I/O device. Well, that's just the implicit, or I/O messaging, of the Ethernet IP standard, right? So we just set up the Productivity 3000 as a scanner and connect it to the ADAM Remote I/O module via Ethernet, and we're done. And the Productivity 3000 software makes it so easy. Here we go. Okay, I've already opened up a new project, ran an Autodetect on the hardware to configure it, and I'm online with the Productivity 3000. To set up a scanner, we just double-click on Hardware Configuration, the Ethernet IP tab, and drag a generic client over into this area over here. Now we just fill in the blanks. Let's give it a name. I'll call this my ADAM-6050. I need to enter the IP address of the ADAM module right here. And I'll go ahead and fill out these tags here so we can monitor the status of this scanner. We already know that we want to use the I/O messaging, not explicit messaging, so we select that one. And now I have some more blanks to fill in. First, we need to create a tag that we can use to turn the scanner on and off. Then I'll go ahead and create some tags so we can monitor the status of this connection. And finally, we fill in the details for the ADAM device. The first tab is the target to originator. That's the ADAM device to us, our input. We want that to be delivered in a unicast, so only comes to us. We'll have the ADAM device send that 4 times a second, that's fine. The connection point for the ADAM device input channel is 102, and I need to create a tag for that input data to end up in. So I'll simply call that my 6050 input. As soon as I click away, the Productivity 3000 reminds me that I haven't defined that tag yet, and it gives me a chance to do so. So let's see. We know that the ADAM device is sending us a 16-bit unsigned integer, so let's change it to that. It's only sending one, so one column is all I need. Perfect. Now, normally in these arrays, you have multiple elements. You can select how many you want to send. We only have one, so of course it's going to send us that one. Great. So it's going to send us a unicast message 4 times a second from this connection point. It's going to put the results in this array, which is only one element large. Let's do the same thing for the output data. This is the data sent from us, the originator, to the target, which is the ADAM device. We'll send that data 4 times a second. Note that this rate does not have to be the same as the input data rate. The connection point for the output on the ADAM is 101. We need to create a data array to put the data into so it can be transferred down to the ADAM. And again, when we click away, the software is going to remind us that we haven't actually created that tag yet. That's another 16-bit unsigned integer, and it's only one element large. And of course, we're going to send that one element down the pipe. Now, some devices require a 4-byte status header to be sent with the output data. The ADAM device is one of those, so we definitely want to make sure that this box is checked. Under configuration data, that connection point is 100. And again, I just got that from the ADAM documentation. We need to create a data array for this. And when we click away, again, the software reminds us we haven't created that yet. So we'll make that a 16-bit unsigned integer, one element. Now, some Ethernet IP devices, while they require this configuration data, don't really require you to send any data with it. And that is the case for the ADAM I/O device. It's a zero-length data, but we still need to send this field. So great, we gave it a name and defined some status tags. We tell the Productivity 3000 the IP address of the ADAM device. And then we set up the I/O messaging for the input, output, and configuration data. That's it, we're done. Now, since I hit OK, the Productivity 3000 is reminding me that I created a bunch of new tags and I haven't defined them yet. It's recommending these types, which all look great, with the exception of the strings. I really like to make these strings kind of long so they can handle just about anything that might come down the pike. So give me a second while I change these. And great, now all of our tags are defined. Well, that's it. We've set up a scanner for the ADAM-6050 Remote I/O device. I do want to do one more thing, though. Let's go back into the device and click this monitor button. What that does is it takes all these tags we created and builds a data view for us. I really love that feature. I don't have to do that manually myself. So we'll call this the ADAM-6050. Great. Just close all this stuff out. We're already online with the Productivity 3000, so all I have to do is transfer this program to the controller. And we're good to go. Okay, well, let's see what's going on. Let's bring up that data view. and there's all the tags we created, and in particular, here's our input array, our output array, and our configuration data. To turn this scanner on, all we have to do is toggle that enable bit that we created. So I'll toggle that, write it out, and look, we're connected to the ADAM device, and we have a successful connection. So now that we're enabled, data is being transferred back and forth between the ADAM device and the Productivity 3000. Well, let's try it. The inputs on the ADAM device are pulled up. So if I simply ground the D0 pin, then sure enough, that data is transferred from the ADAM device to the Productivity 3000 in the background, and it just appears in its input array I created right here as the D0 bit. If I release that one and ground the D1 bit, then sure enough, that information is transferred from the ADAM device up to the Productivity 3000 and dropped into this input array that we created. Note that on the Productivity 3000, it's easy to change the view of this. Right now we're viewing it in decimal. Let's change that view to hex and see how that looks. Bring all this back. And there it is. It's a little bit easier to read that way. Okay, let's go ahead and do one more. I'm going to ground pin D7. Let's see what happens. And sure enough, that input data is transferred from the ADAM Remote I/O device up to the Productivity 3000 and dropped into this input array where our ladder logic can use it however it wants. Perfect. And again, keep in mind, this is all automatically happening in the background. Our ladder code doesn't have to do anything to fetch that data. It's just there, ready to use. How about the output data? Well, it's the exact same thing. We just modify this array, and the Ethernet IP automatically transfers that down to the ADAM device for us. Let's try it. I have some LEDs connected to the output pins on this ADAM device so we can see the results. Note that on this device, it's the upper 8 bits of the 16-bit word that drives the outputs. So let's change this output to hex so it's easier to see. And let's turn on that 8th bit, which would be output bit 0 on the device. And write that out. And sure enough, output bit D0 lights up. Let's try D1. And sure enough, that lights up. Let's go crazy here, and let's put alternating bits in. And sure enough, those light up. Normally, your ladder code would be setting these bits, of course. We're just using this data view here because it's easy and to show you that no ladder code is required to do the actual transfer of the data down to the ADAM device. So bottom line here is all we did is to set up a scanner to talk to an ADAM I/O device. We just went in hardware config, we dropped a generic client in here, and filled in the blanks. Once we were done with that, we brought up our data view, enabled the device, we checked that we were connected and we had a successful connection, and then all we had to do was watch the input values as they changed on the device and write output values to drive the output pins on the device. That's it. That's all there is to setting up a Productivity 3000 to work with an Advantech ADAM Remote I/O device. Now, could we add more devices? Sure. Go back to hardware config, grab another generic client, fill in the blanks. You can add as many as you want to. It's easy. Check out the other videos in this series for more tips on using Ethernet IP with the Productivity 3000. Performance plus value. That's productivity. From AutomationDirect.com.